Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. We have an equation with a complex number. Z squared is equal to 3 plus 4i. We want to find the two roots satisfying this equation. Actually, we want to find the two square roots of this complex number 3 plus 4i. Let me show you the first method here. The first way is this one. Let the z be some a plus bi, any complex number, and this a and b are reals, and I squared is negative 1 by definition. Now, plugging into the equation, this one will have a plus bi all squared is equal to 3 plus 4i. Now, let's just expand this part. We have a squared plus 2 times abi plus bi all squared is equal to 3 plus 4i. Now this part will become a squared plus 2abi. This is b squared I squared. Let me write here. Bi squared is equal to b squared times I squared, and I squared is negative 1 by definition, so we have negative b squared. This is equal to negative b squared, and we have 3 plus 4i right hand side. Now, my friends, this equation will be solved by a system. The real parts here are a squared minus b squared, and right hand side this is equal to 3. A squared minus b squared is equal to negative 3, sorry, positive 3. And the imaginary part here is 2abi, and here we have 4i. This is 2ab is equal to 4, or we have a times b is equal to 2, and again a squared minus b squared is equal to 3. We have a system, as I said, of two variables. The solutions are not too difficult, actually. We have a times b is equal to 2. Just checking this 2 and 1, we can find 2 times 1 is equal to 2, and 2 squared minus 1 squared, which is 4 minus 1, is equal to 3. By checking this number, actually, we can find AB can be 2 and 1, or just negative 2 and negative 1 is the other solution to this system. Since the multiplication is again positive and the square of negative numbers is again positive, the set of solutions is these two numbers. So we have, let me write the result. Result is z is equal to a plus bi, so z1, the first root, is equal to 2 plus 1 times I, and z2 is equal to negative 2, negative I. These are the two square roots of the number 3 plus 4i. And this is the first method I want to show you. The second one, let me show you here. The second method maybe the polar coordinates. Let me show you the complex plane, the real and imaginary axis. Now this number 3 plus 4i is somewhere here. This is 3, this is 4i, and this is our z. The length here r is equal to 5 by the Pythagorean theorem. This is a 3, 4, 5 triangle. R is equal to, let me write here, 5. And theta here we have the angle theta with tangent theta, say, is equal to 4 over 3. Now by these are 4, this 3 plus 4i number, 3 plus 4i is equal to r times e to the power I theta, which is 5 times e to the power I theta, with tangent theta is equal to 4 over 3. Now how to square root this number? How to square root this number? Let me just take the square root of this and the other parts. The square root of 3 plus 4i should be equal to square root of 5 times e to the power of I theta, which is also equal to the square root of 5 times e to the power I theta divided by 2, theta times 1 over 2, actually, the half of theta. But how to find this half of theta? Let me show you a useful method. Let's just draw our triangle here. This 4, 3 and 5 triangle. We have theta here. The tangent of theta is equal to 4 over 3. Now let's just have a 5 unit segment here and just adjoin these two points. Now we have a triangle here with two equal sides, so the angles, the two angles, should be equal also, and the sum of these two is equal to theta, so the angle here and here it also is equal to theta divided by 2. Let me tell you again, we just draw a line segment here as long as the hypotenuse, and we have a triangle here with two equal sides. Then the base angles should be equal and they sum up to this theta, so each one of these two angles are theta divided by 2. Now the triangle here with 4 and 8 gives us the tangent of theta divided by 2. Tangent theta over 2 is equal to 4 divided by 8, which is 1/2. Let me calculate this part. We have 4 squared plus 8 squared is equal to, let's say, m squared. This is 16, this is 64. This is equal to m squared. 80 is equal to m squared. M is equal to root 80, or just 4 times root 5. This m is equal to 4 times root 5. Let me complete the question. We have square root of 3 plus 4i. Square root of 3 plus 4i is equal to root 5 times e to the I theta divided by 2, which is also equal to root 5 times cosine theta over 2 plus I times sine theta over 2. And we have, let me write directly, we have cosine theta over 2 is equal to this 8 over 4 times root 5. 8 over 4 times root 5, which can be cancelled, plus I times, this is 4 divided by 4 times root 5. And distributing this root 5, we will have This root 5 will cancel. 8 over 4 plus I times 4 over 4, which is 2 plus I. This is the first square root of 3 plus 4i by using this Euler's notation and some trigonometric ways. And the second one is also the negative of this. So z squared is equal to 3 plus 4i. Again, gives the first square root is equal to 2 plus I. And the second one is negative 2, negative I. Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.